friends, this is here from Code with Jerry channel. Welcome again to my channel Code with Jerry. In this video, we are going to see how you can fire up your Node.js development using VS Code. Actually, recently in one of the videos, I shown about how to debug React.js in VS Code. After watching this video, some user asked, like, can we do same for the Node.js? So for this video is for all of this kind of people who don't know, like, VS Code is having inbuilt support for Node.js. So let's get started. Okay, so let me show you what I have done till now to save my time. So basically what I have done is, like, I have created a my app with express generator which create this thing, and then what I done is, like, I have installed, so it is installed all the packages there, and then I have opened this app here. So here you can see, like, it is a pretty standard app where you got routes, you got views related to this, and this is a public view because I have created that with bug. Here you can see that, and this is a pretty standard basic app, and if you run it with npm start, it will load same thing in the browser. So this is a pretty kind of basic app by the user. It will say, like, right now nothing is going on. So basically it's a basic express app. So now what I wanted to show you is, like, here you can see, like, I have got all the inbuilt views and all the stuffs from the package.json, and here also, like, I can get my full intellisense there, whatever the packages are there. Let's say if I am using the sync, and if I on control and space, like, I will get the second version of the thing. So these all things are done with the some of the extensions of the VS Code and some of the inbuilt functions. I have already shown you my favorite extensions there. There are two things which I am using right now. One is npm intellisense, which is a extension which I already mentioned in my previous video, and the second one is the npm support for the VS Code. Like, it will give me all the intelligence in my second project. And now talking about the things related to, like, VS Code, so here you can see, like, you got full functionality of all the required modules, and here also I can do whatever I wanted to have. So that is another, like, it's a full-fledged Node.js editor, and here I will go all these things. Here you can see, like, yeah, I can do response for try, even I can do render, even I can do redirect. So these all things are there with proper help and proper intelligence. That is the one greatest thing about the VS Code here. Next thing is the debugging. Like, VS Code supports inbuilt debugging itself. So what you need to do is click on this, and right now it's saying no configuration. So what we need to do is to click on this, and we can, like, it will ask for us to select the environment. Right now we don't want to debug Chrome, right now we wanted to debug Node.js. So it will create a file there. So it will take some time to load these things and fire up the environment. Okay, it is saying the port is already in use because we have run it from here. Now let's again do the same thing and click on Node.js. And now if I run this app, so it is running because like we have run here, and now I create a checkpoint here to load the checkpoint. Here you can see like it is a top corner checkpoint where I can see all the steps, even I can see all the requests and response things here. Like this is a great thing because like you are getting inbuilt debugging with VS Code itself without to do anything about it. So that is the greatest thing, and it's free of charge because it is open source, and we are getting all this coolest stuff with your Node.js environment. So you don't need any other additional things here because like VS Code is already there. So hey Adi, this is fun for you, and do subscribe. Hey guys, do subscribe to my channel because I am going to put lot more cool video about this kind of stuff, because like this is a awesome editor and like you can do lots many things with this editor. So thank you very much watching this video, and if you like this video then subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon and click on the like button. Thank you, see you next time.